In this video, we'll deploy the Sharetribe Web Template to the online hosting service, Render. To follow this tutorial, you need to have a Render account, which is available at render.com. And in addition to that, you need to be hosting your custom code in a GitHub repository. Once you've done that and created a Render account, you can navigate to New and create a new web service. You'll need to select Build and Deploy from the Git repository, and after that, click on Next. At this point, you'll need to connect to a repository, so select the specific repository you want to deploy. After that, you'll need to choose a name for your web service. You can leave all the other options as they are by default. Before creating the web service, you need to navigate to Advanced and add all the environment variables. There's two ways to add the environment variables in Render. The first option is to add the environment variables one by one through the user interface. The second option is to add the secret file. We'll be using the secret file because it's faster and more practical. Click on Add Secret File and name the file as .env. You'll want to copy and paste the contents of the .env template, which is located in the root directory of the web template repository. To do that, you can click on Raw and select or copy and paste that into the file contents. Before you save the file, you want to set the correct environment variables. You can get the Sharetribe SDK client ID from the Sharetribe console. Your Stripe publishable key can be found in your Stripe account, and you can get your Mapbox access token from your Mapbox account. In addition, you'll need the Sharetribe SDK client secret, which you can also get from the Sharetribe console. Alternatively, if you're using Google Maps, you'll need to use a Google Maps API key instead of a Mapbox access token. In addition, for your marketplace to function correctly, you'll need to specify a marketplace root URL. You won't necessarily know your marketplace URL before deploying your marketplace for the first time. So what we're going to do is to leave this as is and change it after your marketplace has been deployed. You can keep the rest of the environment variables empty if you're not using the Facebook or Google login, for example. After you've saved the environment variable file, you can click on Create Web Service. After you've clicked on Create Web Service, your deployment will begin. At this point, you'll know the URL of your website. Once you know the URL of your website, you should copy it, navigate back to environment, and go back to editing the secret file we just edited. In the secret file, locate the React App Marketplace root URL environment variable and enter the value we just copied. After that, you can click on Save Changes and click on Manual Deploy. You'll need to select Clear Build Cache and Deploy. After that, all you have to do is to wait for the deployment to finish and you'll be able to view your website on the public internet.